day, black shalom, I'm here for a drink of water. Got it. South there. Shouts out to the 12 tribe. This is the last video for the day. We talk about Israel, Palestine, Gaza, Israelis. I've had a little Jerusalem in here too. Arabs, all that. Like I said, I wasn't going to follow more and more. I kind of did a little bit, but I wasn't going to follow more. I put that up here as, you know, but I'll talk about, I guess, the regions and the people. I'll do that. And we'll see about that. So I got some good information up on here. I don't know. Call it what you want. Now you know. This is what it is. So it could be more. I mean, somebody could have stepped on somebody's toe in the hallway and she could have just cracked off and now the whole country's at war. I don't know how that go, but I guess this is what it's about. Anyway, you did play to the line. Feel free to drink the water. They got it. It's out there. Shouts out to the 12 tribe, man. I support the people, not the cause. Let the people out, man. Cease fire. We can claim land. Next video is the conflict so far over all the years of Gaza and Israel. See y'all tomorrow, man. Anyway, hear the music. I like
the rhyming Peter to pay Paul as long as I stay comfortable. Yeah, cash that paycheck, spend it all on shit that a throne won't pay each part. We'll build that house up big and tall, we'll break the bank to build the world. We're robbing Peter to pay Paul as long as I stay comfortable.
American privilege keeps blurring my vision
as long as I'm comfortable.
Heritage sickness.
The Israel-Palestine conflict, which flared up again in October 7th, 2023, is a deeply rooted issue with layers of historical, religious, and territorial complexities. While many contemporary discussions trace its origins to the establishment of Israel in 1948, its roots delve much deeper, spanning nearly 3,000 years. In the 8th century BCE, the territories now identified as Israel and Palestine were under the dominion of the kingdoms of Judah and Israel. These kingdoms were the political manifestations of various Jewish tribes, concurrently the ancestors of the Palestinians, often referred to as the Philistines in ancient scriptures, occupied a stretch of land from the Gaza Strip to Tel Aviv. The Old Testament, a foundational text for Judaism, cites God's promise of a vast tract of land to Abraham's descendants, the Israelites. This divine promise became a cornerstone for early territorial disputes. By 722 BCE, the Assyrians, under King Sargon II, reshaped the geopolitical landscape by annexing the Kingdom of Israel. To suppress potential rebellions, the Assyrians adopted a strategy of population displacement. This led to the Jews' gradual assimilation with diverse cultures across the Assyrian Empire, diluting their unique identity. The late 7th century BCE saw another power transition as the Babylonians replaced the Assyrians. They controlled vast territories, including Jerusalem. Jewish resistance against Babylonian dominance led to the destruction of Solomon's Temple in 587 BCE, marking the onset of the Babylonian exile. However, the winds of change blew again in 539 BCE when the Persians, under the leadership of King Cyrus the Great, overthrew the Babylonians. Cyrus allowed the exiled Jews to return to Jerusalem. He also sponsored the reconstruction of Solomon's Temple, a significant gesture that endeared him to the Jewish populace. By 63 BCE, the Roman Empire extended its tentacles to Jerusalem. The subsequent centuries under Roman rule were tumultuous for the Jewish community. Two major revolts against the Romans resulted in catastrophic losses for the Jews, leading to a diaspora where many fled Roman persecution. The rise of Christianity in the Roman Empire added another layer of complexity. Jews faced intensified persecution, being blamed for Jesus' crucifixion. This persecution persisted until 638 CE, when Muslims under Caliph Umar conquered the region. This conquest ushered in a period of relative religious tolerance, allowing Jews to return to Jerusalem. For the subsequent centuries, the majority of Jews resided in Europe, where they faced a myriad of challenges, including discrimination, pogroms, and socio-economic restrictions. Conversely, the period of Ottoman dominion in Jerusalem, spanning from 1517 to 1917, was of considerable importance for the Jewish community in the city. The Jewish population in Jerusalem saw a significant uptick during the Ottoman reign. By the onset of the 19th century, Jews emerged as the most substantial religious group in the city. Under the Ottoman administrative structure, Jews were categorized as a dhimmi community, denoting their status as protected non-Muslim subjects. Although they faced certain financial obligations and limitations, they were predominantly allowed the freedom to practice their religious customs unhindered. By the late 19th century, Theodor Herzl, a visionary Jewish journalist, proposed a radical solution, the establishment of a Jewish state in Palestine. His Zionist ideology gained traction, especially after the British government's Balfour Declaration in 1917, which endorsed the idea of a Jewish homeland in Palestine. Post-World War I, the League of Nations granted Britain the mandate over Palestine. This period saw a surge in Jewish immigration, which inevitably heightened tensions between Jews and Arabs. The Arab Revolt of 1936 to 1939, a resistance against British rule and Jewish immigration, led to the British White Paper of 1939, which proposed a joint Arab-Jewish state. However, the horrors of World War II and the Holocaust amplified global support for a Jewish homeland. In 1947, the United Nations proposed a partition plan to divide British Mandate Palestine into separate Jewish and Arab states, with Jerusalem as an international city. The Jewish leadership accepted the UN partition plan, but the Arab leadership did not. On May 14, 1948, David Ben-Gurion declared the establishment of the State of Israel. This declaration was met with military intervention by neighboring Arab states, leading to the 1948 Arab-Israeli War. By the end of the war in 1949, Israel had expanded its territory beyond the UN's proposed borders. The war resulted in a significant Palestinian-Arab refugee crisis. The 1950s saw a series of skirmishes and reprisal attacks between Israel, its Arab neighbors, and Palestinian groups. The tensions culminated in the Six-Day War of 1967. Preempting a perceived Arab attack, Israel launched strikes against Egypt, Jordan, and Syria. In just 6 days, Israel captured the Sinai Peninsula, Gaza Strip, West Bank, Old City of Jerusalem, and the Golan Heights. This victory significantly altered the territorial landscape and further complicated the Israel-Palestine issue. In 1973, Egypt and Syria launched a surprise attack on Israel during Yom Kippur, a major Jewish holiday. Despite initial setbacks, Israel managed to repel the attackers. This war led to the 1978 Camp David Accords, brokered by US President Jimmy Carter. Egyptian President Anwar Sadat and Israeli Prime Minister Menachem Begin negotiated the accords, leading to Egypt formally recognizing Israel and the two nations signing a peace treaty in 1979. As part of the treaty, Israel agreed to withdraw from the Sinai Peninsula, which it had captured from Egypt during the 1967 Six-Day War. Palestinian frustrations with Israeli occupation and settlement expansion in the West Bank and Gaza Strip led to the First Intifada in 1987. This grassroots uprising involved civil disobedience, boycotts, and widespread protests. The violence and Israel's response garnered international attention, highlighting the need for a resolution. The 1993 Oslo Accords marked a significant step towards peace. Israeli Prime Minister Yitzhak Rabin and Palestine Liberation Organization leader Yasser Arafat agreed to mutual recognition. The Accords proposed a phased withdrawal of Israeli forces from parts of the West Bank and Gaza, and the establishment of a Palestinian authority. The Israel's failure to progress on the Oslo Accords promises led to the Second Intifada in 2000. This violent uprising resulted in significant casualties on both sides. In 2005, Israel unilaterally disengaged from the Gaza Strip, evacuating all Israeli settlements. However, this did not lead to peace, as Hamas, a Palestinian militant group, took control of Gaza in 2007. The peace talks that resumed in September 2010 were part of ongoing efforts to resolve long-standing issues between Israel and the Palestinian Authority. However, they quickly broke down due to Israel's settlement activities in the West Bank. Israel has maintained a blockade on the Gaza Strip, aiming to restrict the flow of goods and resources to Hamas, which Israel and several other countries consider a terrorist organization. The blockade has faced widespread international criticism. The May 2010 Gaza flotilla raid heightened tensions as Israeli forces intercepted a flotilla aiming to breach the blockade, resulting in the deaths of 9 Turkish nationals. The conflict has seen ongoing violence, including rocket attacks from Gaza into Israel and retaliatory airstrikes and gunfire by Israeli forces. The release of Israeli soldier Gilad Shalit in October 2011 was a significant moment, as he had been held captive by Hamas in Gaza for over 5 years. Major military operations in Gaza occurred in 2012 and 2014, with significant loss of life and infrastructure damage, particularly during 2014's Operation Protective Edge. In 2018, the move of the US Embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem was a controversial decision that sparked widespread protests. The US's peace plan proposed in 2020 was rejected by the Palestinians, given the inequality in the proposed population exchange and the transfer of 1/3 of Palestine, including most of its best agricultural land, to new Jewish settlers. In the same year, the normalization agreements with the UAE and Bahrain, known as the Abraham Accords, marked a significant shift in regional dynamics, with Israel establishing formal diplomatic relations with these Gulf states. Clashes in the Sheikh Jarrah neighborhood of East Jerusalem over evictions of Palestinian families escalated in April 2021.
Yaakov, you know this is not your house.
Yes, but if I go, you don't go back. So what's the problem? Why are you yelling at me? I didn't do this.
But you...
It's easy to yell at me, but I didn't do this.
You are stealing my house.
And if I don't steal it, someone else is going to steal it.
These tensions ultimately contributed to a full-scale conflict in May 2021 between Israel and Hamas in Gaza. 2022 saw continued violence, including a January rocket attack on Tel Aviv from Gaza and another Gaza conflict. In October 2023, a major infiltration by Hamas from Gaza into Israel occurred, resulting in the killings of over 1,000 civilians and the abduction of around 200 soldiers and civilians. It intensified the ongoing conflict, which continues. Israel retaliated by launching airstrikes on Gaza, resulting in killing thousands of Palestinians, including women and children, according to UN. The story of Israel and Palestine is long and complex, filled with fights over land and differences in beliefs.